Hi there! A couple of months ago, I set myself the challenge to make Zelda the Wind Waker using only JavaScript and a library called threejs. A WebGL library that allows you to create 3D environments in a website, which means the game will run directly into the browser. And I tried to make it in 2 months. In this video, I'll show you how I made this game in 5 steps. But first, here is a small introduction. Ah, the Wind Waker. Definitely one of my favorite game ever. The toonish style, the funny facial expressions, the music of course, like in every Zelda game, and mostly that strong sense of embarking to a new adventure. There was a genuine feeling of freedom as soon as you set the sail with the boat, and it really felt like an open world, which was pretty impressive back in the day in 2002. Now we're in 2023, I've grown and I became a web developer. I've created immersive websites that have won some awards for the last 8 years now. With the experience I've gained in WebGL and JavaScript, I was more confident, and I set myself the crazy challenge to recreate part of the game. Well, at least the ocean maybe, and the fact of sailing in just 2 months. The problem was, I had never coded a video game in my life, only traditional websites. Well, it was time to start. So I took my threejs template repository and started from this white page. My first goal was to recreate the ocean like in the game. Fortunately for me, a great WebGL developer, Nathan Gordon, has already wrote some articles on how to recreate some part of the game in JavaScript in 2016. All the logic was really well explained on the article and I could easily achieve the result. The idea was to draw a big 2D plane, apply the texture from the game, I found them on the internet, and apply multiple scene functions on the fragment shader. A fragment shader, also called a pixel shader, is a program that will display all the pixels of an object in a 2D screen space. Here, I used it in WebGL to display the white and blue texture of the ocean. So, thanks to all these scene functions, the texture could wiggle. Then, in the vertex shader, which is the program which is giving you the position of each of the points of a 3D object, so here it was just a plane, we again apply different sinus functions on the x-axis and on the z-axis to create a wave effect. Once we had that, we negate it to the position 0, which is the central object position, and that way the central object is always ticking on the ocean. Then I just needed to offset the texture to make the feeling of movement, even if the object in the end stays in the middle. Alright, so then for the clouds, it was pretty simple. I managed to find some textures of the game on the website and I put the clouds in circles around the center and then I just made them move randomly. For the horizon, I put multiple planes around the center of the sphere again and I make a gradient using a fragment shader. I know I'm going fast on the technical aspects, but the purpose of this video is just to show you the different steps quickly. If you guys want to have more details about the code itself, let me know in the comments and I'll be happy to make a series of videos of each step I made for this game with all the code explained. Great, I had an environment working, was looking pretty great for an ocean, but now I needed to find the boat. Thankfully, I could find a 3D model on the website linked by Nathan Gordon. But when I opened it in Blender, the head was weird. The bones of the objects were not perfect, so I had to move them individually to have the final boats. And voila! Then I could just export the boat in Blender in the GLTF file format, just to easily import it in threejs. Cool, so I had the boat in the ocean, it was moving, but now I needed to add the realistic movement in the water. So I found the texture of the trail in the same link as before. You can find it in the description of the video. And then with some tricky shader, I managed to draw the texture on the surface of the ocean. So on the surface of the 2D plane. Then I make it distorted a little bit on the left and the right, depending of if the user is turning. That way I created the impression of turning in the ocean. For the sail, I use Blender to morph the vertex of the object. Then I could easily apply the morphing in threejs using scale x positively to go on the left and negatively to go on the right. And then I could increase that value based on the speed of the boat. In the game, we can see these shapes of water pushed in the air by the boat. So I got this idea. Okay, that looks pretty ugly when you look at it on Blender first, but with some fragment shaders and playing with the scales in 3GS, I managed to have a similar effect. Here's the result. Not the best, but it looks fine, right? And for the final touches, I added particles when the boat moved around it in front, and I also added a jump with some particles dropping when the boat hits the water. Good, finally it was time to add our main character, Link. The model was also available on the website, so I opened it in Blender like for the boat. Cool, but wait, there is actually no skin bones? That means I could not put Link in any position apart from the T-pose. Well, that's pretty annoying. My first attempt was to make my own bones in Blender. I tried really hard, but I was never happy with the result. As you can see, the movement didn't feel natural. So I had to find another solution. So I asked myself, okay, maybe I can find the model somewhere else with the bone already included? But where? There is no other website that are sharing these game models. And after some research, I finally found this. And it was like the Graal for me. A guy named Lago Lunatic created a GitHub with a tutorial that can convert back and forth Wind Waker's models between different formats. Amazing. The main goal of this GitHub repository was to replace the models in the game by custom ones in an emulated version of the game. But in my case, I just needed to convert the model from the game to a format that is compatible in Blender. The first thing to do was to install Dolphin. This is the Nintendo GameCube emulator. And then get an ISO version of the game. That way, I could even play the real game on my computer. Pretty cool. Then, by following the tutorial, I could extract any model from the game using a script from the GitHub repository. They even used the Link model in the tutorial, so it was pretty easy to find it. Cool, finally, I got the bones of Link and I could put it in any position I wanted. So I tried to put it in a position that was matching with the boat as much as I could. I even added a small animation using the animation mixer from 3GS, so Link is now more alive. I even play with the bone of the hat, so when the boat was moving, I could simulate the effect of the wind on Link's hat. Now, it was time to add lighting and shadows to make it look even better. I created a custom shader that is basically the same thing as using a shadow shader, starting from a directional light and applying a shadows on the strategic part of the mesh. But unlike other light material, you just apply a small gradient on the base color to apply the shadow. There is no light reflection, metalness, specular effect, just a simple dark gradient. That way, we can get a cool tone effect on any 3D object in the scene. To make the game more realistic, I wanted to cast the shadow of the boat on the ocean, like in the real game. For that, I created my own shadow map system using the Mizaki's tutorial on shadow maps. I strongly recommend her tutorial, by the way. Mizaki is a really talented WebGL developer, and thanks to that, you will really understand how shadow maps work. I've put the link in the description. Cool, so now I got the shadow of the boat being casted onto the water and onto the ocean. The little image you can see on the top left corner is called a depth map. It represents, with a gradient from black to white, the distance for all objects in the scene between their position and the source of the light. So If an object is really close to the light, it's gonna be white, and if it's very far, it's gonna be black. I was pretty happy with the result of Link and his boats, but the website was pretty boring, as you could only navigate indefinitely in this empty ocean. So I decided to create a minigame. But for that, I needed models from the game. Remember that thanks to that repository I found on GitHub, I could get any model from the game. So I tried to find some of them, but it was pretty hard. Like, the name didn't mean anything sometimes, it was just letters, sometimes it was in Japanese. Well, it was not easy. But you know, after some times, I managed to find anything I wanted. And I was pretty happy with it. I've got rupees for points, barrels for obstacles, and warship for enemies. Perfect. I could create a game into the game. But before that, I needed to have floating object in the ocean. And for that, I needed to create a height map. A height map in games is commonly used to generate landscapes, really fast and with good performance. It consists of using a 2D texture, black and white, to create a terrain, where white can be the highest point, like a mountains of the terrains, and black can be the lowest point, like a deep sea. In my case, I needed to generate a height map from the waves I already had. So I generated in a render target, where each point in the y-axis of my ocean corresponds to a pixel. White will be the highest point of the wave, and black the lowest point of the wave. From that, I could exactly know how high an object should be in the ocean, depending on his coordinates. So the object could follow the wave like it was floating in the ocean. It was working well, but it was a bit shaky, so I increased the map size for more pixel precision, and I used an interpolation in code to smooth the values. Once I got that, I could create a simple game where you have to navigate while grabbing rupees and avoid obstacles, with 3 life. I also added walls. For that, I created them on Blender, taking stone walls from an island of the game. I won't go too much into details, otherwise there would be a spoil for anyone who wants to try the game. So go for it and have fun after the video, the link is in the description. In the original game, there was a life cycle day and night, and sometimes a storm could come. It really felt like we were living an adventure, alone with your boat, in this wild environment that the ocean is. I wanted to recreate a similar effect, so I added 4 different ambients, transitioning one after another. A blue sky day, a grey stormy weather, an orange dawn, and a night full of stars. I even added other elements from the game, like 2D plane waves, ice particles, and the wind. By the way, the articles of Nathan Gordon helped me a lot for the wind as well. So, thank you again, Nathan. The Rupees game was fun, but I thought that the explore mode was too empty. So I added random objects as you move. Then I found 6 islands that I loved from the game, and I placed them all around the boat. I also found the LOD versions, level of details, which means the low poly version of island, to display them when they are far from Link to improve the performance. I also put some sound design and music from the game. Oh, and if you'd like to try the website, the link is in the description. And it also works on mobile. Alright, and after these 2 months of hard work, I think it's finally time to show you the preview. Alright, that's it for this video. It was super fun to make this website. I hope you guys liked it. And if you did, just leave a like and subscribe for more to support me. I know it was not a tutorial this time. It was pretty different. If you guys want me to make like a video on just how I made the ocean, for example, with all the code, just let me know in the comments. I think that could be pretty interesting. Also, let me know what part of the game you want me to teach you. Like, for example, I could do a video on the lighting or on the links, animation and facial expression. You can also support me on Patreon. That will help me to make more videos like this and give me more time to make tutorials. It will also give you access to all of the code of my previous tutorials by subscribing to the Patreon. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you guys liked it. And if you haven't tried the game, or the website I should say, yet, just go for it now. The link is in the description. Cheers!